Greetings, and welcome to this week's Primed Insight. My name is Mark Railton, and I'm an account manager here at BlastOne. Perhaps nothing affects an industrial painter's project deadlines and cure times as much as the cold weather of the seasons. Even without massive temperature drops, however, painting contractors are always interested to learn ways to accelerate curing. So, in this week's Primed Insight, we'd like to offer some basic principles of accelerating cure using heat. These are meant for contractors unable to take advantage of environmentally controlled paint booths and need to get the job done on site or in less than ideal facilities. The first point that is absolutely critical is to always understand and follow the coating manufacturer's minimum and maximum requirements for air temperature, coating temperature, and substrate temperature. Most coating data sheets use 21 degrees Celsius or 70 degrees Fahrenheit as the standard temperature for their cure rates. It's very important to understand that a manufacturer's cure speed is based on the substrate temperature, not ambient air temperature. Experienced painters know the folly of bringing a cold steel pipe indoors and trying to blast and paint it while it's still as cold as the inside of a refrigerator. Huge mistake. The essential principle here is to effectively manage the substrate temperature before, during, and after you apply the coating. Keep it at the 21 degrees Celsius or 70 degrees Fahrenheit mark, or hopefully much warmer. Here's why. There's a common rule of thumb that applies to curing typical epoxies and urethanes. The rule of thumb is this. Every 10 degrees Celsius rise in temperature from the manufacturer's recommended substrate temperature, let's say 21 degrees Celsius, 70 degrees Fahrenheit, will double the curing speed. Yes, twice as fast. So 31 degrees Celsius, or 88 degrees Fahrenheit, will cure the paint twice as fast. 41 Celsius, 106 Fahrenheit, will cure it four times as fast. Conversely, every 10 degrees Celsius drop in temperature from recommended substrate temperature will half the speed. So 11 degrees Celsius, or 52 degrees Fahrenheit, will take twice as long as normal. 1 degree Celsius, or 34 degrees Fahrenheit, will take four times longer. What else can be done with heat to speed up the process? I have three more principles to share, but first, if you enjoy these Primed Insights, please hit the like button, leave a comment or question, or subscribe below. Another principle that will help you accelerate the cure is to warm the coating. If you can preheat the paint before applying the coating, the elevated temperature will both kickstart the curing and help with flow and atomization. Warning: when heating paint, you're going to increase the evaporation rate of anything that's volatile, solvents or VOCs. Therefore, take extra precautions to protect against explosions, fire, or increased exposure to chemicals by employees. If the steel substrate being painted is outdoors or otherwise in a cold environment such as an unheated warehouse or garage, it's recommended to fashion a makeshift encapsulation with some form of sheeting barrier to isolate, like an igloo, the work product from the colder outdoor temperature. Then use an indirect fired burner to heat the igloo, effectively turning it into a quasi-greenhouse. Are there exceptions for direct fired heaters? Yes. But as a principle, for safety's sake, use indirect fired burners. This will assist in maintaining very warm ambient and substrate temperatures and reduce cure times. Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight. See you next week.